Few predators in the animal kingdom are more iconic than the lion. But its majestic looks and status have made it one of the most desirable creatures to exploit for profit. A new book by businessman and author Lord Ashcroft now reveals the true extent to which lions are being horrifically exploited for canned trophy hunting, selfie tourism, and the use of body parts in Asian medicine and jewellery. Ian Michler has investigated the lion breeding industry for more than 20 years and supported the new expose.
And I started going onto these properties in the 90s and then early 2000s when I really got more involved, 2000, 2001, too. I was absolutely shocked at not so much the number of farms, but the number of lions that were being kept in really confined areas. Now you have a whole series of really brutal revenue streams where these lions get used in this kind of chain that they'll either end up in a bag of bones going to Asia, being sold off for breeding stock, or being fattened up or aged for a canned hunt. We have our entire conservation community, from the African Lion Working Group to every major African conservation agency dealing with lions, claiming very clearly there is no conservation value, no conservation benefit to any of these facilities and the lions that they produce. That's because the pro-trade lobby groups, the trophy hunting lobby groups have all started getting involved. They've got their consultants, their scientists, to put forward counter-narratives. There's a significant sum of money involved. There are a lot of people in powerful positions who benefit and who just work in these industries.
During the course of my conservation work fighting against the illegal wildlife trade, we've come across a number of examples of animal cruelty and exploitation. But last year, we came across an operation offering a walking with lion experience for tourists. The managers there said it's part of a DNA conservation program, but this makes no sense at all to anyone that works in the field of conservation. So I went to the operation to find out what really was going on. So this is Horseback Africa. We're just outside Johannesburg. And what's been advertised here is the lion, walking with lion experience. The manager at the reserve told me that the cubs were bred to increase the DNA pool of lions in South Africa. Yet it was clear that this was simply a business being run for profit. Baby lions are taken off the mother after just one day and are put in a separate cage for the public to interact with. The mother is then forced to breed again. Tourists looking for selfies during a close-up lion encounter are unknowingly supporting the exploitation of wildlife.
I had my suspicions that this is unsustainable and that no one really knows where those babies go to. How can you keep an industry which is fueled on baby lion cubs? Because what happens when they get to 1 to 2 years old? They're too big to walk with, they're too big to handle for the public, which presents an issue. They're then sold on, and clearly there's not enough zoos, there's not enough places that can take these animals. So there's a potential that these animals end up as a canned hunting trophies. They end up in the crosshairs of the hunting industry. I don't know for sure, but it's something that we need to investigate further.
We were unable to find out what happened to those young lion cubs at the time. But now in a new book, Unfair Game by Lord Ashcroft, he's fully exposed the extent of lion exploitation across southern Africa. In an exclusive interview, Lord Ashcroft reveals the findings from his investigation.
I love nature and I also love South Africa. And when I heard about lion farming from conservationists and experts that I met, I was shocked. I decided to find out more about the stories that I'd been told.
And when I realized the scale of this scandal and that there are about 12,000 captive born lions and only 3,000 wild lions, I launched an undercover investigation, and because I knew it was the only way to expose the truth. Undercover operations carry many risks. They're complicated to set up, they are time consuming. And in the case of lion farming, dangerous too. This is a trade with links to international crime networks and a $1 billion black market in wildlife. But I don't think most tourists who interact with lions in South Africa, in fact, have a clue that they're exploiting wildlife. I mean, this part of the lion trade is very clever. The owners of these tourist attractions are actually exploiting not just the lions, but the tourists too. And I would say this to all tourists, stay away from lions. They're not designed to be handled by you. And certainly by visiting them, you're only encouraging more to be bred. Oh. One of the most shocking aspects of my undercover operation was that when it ended, my team took their findings to a senior police officer in South Africa who specialized in wildlife issues. Not only did he not read the evidence file they gave him, but having rejected it, he also threatened to put them in prison. Lion farming is a four-stage process. As cubs, they're taken from their mothers and used as tourist magnets. When older, they entertain tourists on lion walking excursions. Then later, they're shot in a canned hunt, or they're slaughtered for their bones and then stripped for their parts, which are sold in Asian wildlife markets. I had meetings with both Michael Gove, who was then Secretary of State for the Environment, and then with Zach Goldsmith, who I believe is now the Secretary of State in the same department, in order to pursue the thought that the body parts at least should be banned from being brought into the United Kingdom. Thousands of lion bones are smuggled out of South Africa each year to feed the Asian market for big cat products and so-called traditional medicines. And experts quoted in the book say a major public health incident will occur in Asia as a result of its people's rampant consumption of lion bones. After the first investigation, and that was the one which the Mail on Sunday ran for about 10 pages, we actually paid an undercover operative to pay for and kill a lion. And this lion was Simba. But the whole setup was getting to the point of shooting the lion and then finding a reason not to do so. But as we had paid for the lion, we knew if we finished the investigation there, the lion would then be taken in another hunt and killed. And so we decided that the appropriate thing for us to do was to save Simba, find a secure place for him where he could live out the rest of his life.
The exploitation of the natural world creates zoonotic diseases, which is responsible for global pandemics such as the coronavirus. Apart from it being morally unjustified to keep magnificent species such as the lion in confined spaces before they're shot by hunters or killed for their bones, if humanity doesn't get a grip of the illegal wildlife trade and the exploitation of animals, we're almost certain to have more pandemics, and in the future, they could be even more deadly.